lose things. When you water glass and work on ships, stuff's gonna get in the water, no matter how careful you are. So that's really the concern of me and I think most of the area people who live on Young Island and probably Walla Island also.
Thank you, Mr. Brown.
Mr. Vane, do us a favor.
I'm gonna say that I live on Walla Island as well. I support everything that's been said here previously. The other thing is that the establishment of the mooring fields and the dock extending out an additional 200 feet, maybe a little bit more than the present dock, is going to impair the water usability by boats. And in addition, those mooring fields are right on the mud flats where the oyster and every boat that's going to be moored there leaks oil. And this is a tidal wash. During high tide, this tide comes in and brings water back into the marshes, and the low tide, the fresh water flushes it out. And so it's going to create a significant impact on any wildlife and any shellfish that are in those areas.
Thank you. Mr. Bruno, Bobby Bruno.
Proponent of property rights, but that's going to both ways. If I did something objectionable on my property and it affected the value of your property, you have every right to speak, explore, and argue with us. And I think that's the purpose of tonight's meeting. So again, I oppose this based upon all the comments of the committee. Thank you.
Mrs. Meyer, Renee Meyer.
It's all yours, John.
Well, we have lived out here a while, and we know the Stevens family. And I was so proud of the things that you said. And it was good to hear the explanation. I do have to say, though, if there's any other way to take this off the water, because this is yours, and you do what you want with it. But this is everybody's, and I think that's why you're here tonight. The water is everybody's. So if there's any way to rework it so that it's not so much on the water and more on your land, it would be wonderful. I don't know if that's doable, but that's what it is.
Thank you. Mr. Betts.
Thank you. I'll try to be brief and grab it. Betts in the Guatemala Islands. I want to echo a lot of the sentiments that have been spoken here today. Some were much better articulated than what I could possibly say. I was, again, we all here, I think, mostly of like mind, so again, we're not direct in charge DHEC, what they're doing, and I'm agreeing with your basic charge here of 7, the extent of economic benefits as compared with benefits of preservation. You know, and number 10, you know, the extent to which the proposed use could affect the value of enjoyment of adjacent owners. But I want to make one thing clear. I'm a capitalist growing group. I'm a business owner. I was nominated for one of the fastest growing companies in the state this year. And I respect fellow business owners, but at the same time, I'm in that million-dollar category. I could have bought anywhere I wanted. I choose to travel every day from the shipyard in North Charleston to here. You were just in the paper, Posting Courier, for congratulations on building your first full ship. That to me is not an ongoing current business model. That is a future expansion. You want to replace your two buoys for a more permanent structure? Great, no problem. But that's two. You're proposing 6. So I feel there's a little bit of just disingenuous lead-in here. I've heard from Mr. Rhodes here. He said, hey, we're going to put some parking. And then it turned into rezoning into light industrial. So I would encourage you, if you want to gain support from the community, just be straightforward. She said, hey, is there another way? Because the waterway is all of ours. If I wanted to put a dock on the other side of the creek, you would laugh at me. Well, why is there a double standard for a commercial versus a residential? So we just don't want to be a camel in those situations as far as future expansion of the shipyard. We all knew he was there. I haven't met him. You know, when we chose to purchase our property, we go, okay, that's something that we can live with. We can't live with more. And DHEC, I mean, I think if you do a thorough evaluation of your own rules and regulations, you'll come on to the side of us and decline this permit. Thank you.
Our next speaker is Ms. Link, Sandra Link.
Hi, I'm Sandra Link, and my husband and I live across the way from Stevens Towing. We've lived there 5 or 6 years. And we, just like everybody else, moved there because of the serenity and the wildlife and the quietness. And we knew that already the lights that are across the way are a little cumbersome, and you can see those, and they make it not as enjoyable as it could be, but we knew that that was something that we had to decide the pros and cons on. So we have learned to live with that, and it's fine. But if it gets worse, I was telling people, you're going to have blackout curtains in your whole house because it's going to be so bright that you wouldn't be able to enjoy just looking out at the stars at night and just, you know, being out there. But my big concern listening to all of this is the wildlife, the shell, the oyster beds, the contamination of the water, the safety of the water. You know, I sit out there on my dock and I watch the kids doing on the sea-doos. I watch them out there tubing. And I think, you know, if all this traffic is going to be out there, what's going to be the safety of the kids and the people that are out there boating for the enjoyment of being out in this area? It's like you said, it's the river is everybody's river. It's not just one person's river. And they wouldn't let me go out into the middle of the river and build some huge thing that I wanted for my convenience. And so I think that the community needs to be taking into consideration about this, because it's it belongs to everybody. And I agree with everything that's been said.
Mr. Smith, Benjamin Smith.
Quick comments. Vice President of Operations at Stevens Towing. I've been working for Stevens for 28 years. So I've seen a lot of changes at Stevens in those 28 years. The company's equipment base has grown by a factor of 10. The yard, the shipyard remains the same as it was when I started at Stevens. We haven't done any major improvements in that shipyard in the 28 years that I've been there. The last major improvement was done about 3 years after I started, which we built Railway 3, which is a 3,200 ton capacity railway. This is the first time and since I've been there that we've asked to do any improvements. Otherwise, the yard exists the way it has been since I've been there. So this is our first request. We know you're our neighbors. We value your comments. I'm in the office just about every day of the week. If you ever want to come by and sit down and talk with us about issues, we'd love to do so. We're not here to ruin your property values. We're not trying to injure you in any way. We value the water quality as well. We don't wish to harm. We just wish to continue to grow. We support 175 families. 100 of those are crewmen that you don't even see. 75 work around the shipyard. These are high wage jobs. We pay far more than most companies in the area. So that's all I want to say.
Mr. Boyd, Jack Boyd.
Thank you. I'm the Vice President of Finance at Stevens Towing, been there about 5 years. And I'd just like to make 2 points of clarification. One is that, again, on the mooring field that this photograph shows, we are not increasing the capacity of the mooring field. We're replacing one type of mooring with another. There will not be any additional capacity for more barges than the mooring field is currently approved for. Our application does not request that. One other comment I wanted to make, you can see this shows where the travel lift piers are looking to go. The 1,000-ton lift pier is going to go right in this area here is the plan. That's what the application requests. And what I'd like to point out is that that pier is going to be 365 feet long. Just for comparison, this pier is 350 feet. So if that pier was in existence and we were looking at a photograph, there would be no discernible difference in size with the pier right beside it. So, thank you.
Mrs. Rogers, Judy Rogers.
I'm not Judy. I don't know what just happened. Normally, when I'm in front of a group, I'm singing. So I sing better than my song. But I'm about 3 lots now, which would be in this vicinity right here. Most of the homeowners that have been out there acknowledges that Stevens has been there, and it's been fine. But this changes that we're about to receive now is a little devastating. First of all, we make a lot of great improvements with the property values out there with our homes. A lot of homes have a lot of glass on the back. We have a lot of glass to the water. The mooring, as you can see again, with the lighting, would not be very attractive for us. We're also concerned about the environmental impact of what's going to take place. It's strange. I usually tell jokes. I'm a jokester. I like to have a lot of fun. But I think I got laughed at. I just stood in this room about 2 months ago when they was trying to get approval for light industrial for a parking lot. My statement was, I didn't approve of that. There was a parking lot they were already using. I've never seen it near capacity. There was plenty of room. It really didn't make sense for me, to me, that they was going to have this parking lot. And I said, the first thing you know, light industrial down from a residential area doesn't help home values at all. And here again, 2 months ago, approximately 2 months ago, I stood there and said, the first thing you get, a light industrial parking lot of some nature, and then what's next and what's next. Little did I apparently know, I was probably being laughed at because this has had to be in planning for a long time. So I'm concerned about the lighting issues, the environmental impact, the travel of the highway going by my house with any additional employees, the movement in the river with any additional tugboats or towboats. It's, you know, we've got this beautiful place, and we believe that the town of Vega should agree to that. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Davis, Richard Davis.
Mr. Millett, my area is an interest of the grass law.
And the last person who signed up to speak is Mr. If I'm mispronouncing this, Craig Carolin.
Okay, you're not alone. You're not alone.
Thank you.
And Mr. Fred, you actually 2 years ago, we moved to Waddamaw from Mount Pleasant, which I couldn't wait to get out of because of the crowd. So when I drive back to my business in Mount Pleasant, when I come across the S.L. Jenkins Bridge, I'm a little, I've arrived to a peaceful place. My concern is we live actually in the public market, and we're directly across from the small creek that comes through. We can see and hear the noise. We can see the lights. I don't mind the nice ferry boats that you have in there. The little lights come out at night. We sit out and have a glass of wine. That's all good. But I just don't want to see, I don't want to see barges out in the middle. I mean, we fish out there, we crab, shrimp. And like I said, I couldn't wait to build my dock. And you approved that 2 years ago. We bought the property. We're there now, much less my wife doesn't, the neighbors don't want to see it, everyone here doesn't want to see it. The peaceful tranquility of the area, just looking out there and seeing boats sitting in the water is going to disturb me. Not to mention my dogs, because they don't like the boats. They're big bulldogs and they bark at everything that they've done. So I just.
Thank you.
We got three more speakers that signed up. We got Brittany Corbin.
I'm Brittany Corbin. I live down Simmons Bluff Road. I didn't write anything down. I'm opposed to this work. I kind of echo a lot of the people saying, and I'll direct it to the director. I live right off of Simmons Bluff. I'm real close to Stephen Snowden. I woke up for Saturday morning, and they're blasting the ship right there. There's crap flying all over the air, and that's how we get home Saturday morning. You know, you guys in Waddamaw, you're not nearly as close as I am. I mean, I see it every morning. McCarty, Keith mentioned something about burn, and the gentleman who spoke earlier said that you got a little pushback, there's a parking lot or something they're building. I remember that meeting. I came and spoke at that meeting, and I asked them to extend the burn they were building a little bit farther to for a noise barrier, and people looked at me like I had three heads. You're talking a multi-million-dollar operation, and they can't afford some more dirt for a berm. And apparently there's a berm there. It's news to me. I'd like to go see it, and I'll probably do it after I leave this meeting to see what kind of berm they came up with. So, based on that past experience, the fact that you're going to be pushing these docks out, or these piers out into navigable waters, into intercoastal waterway, some of that strip in Charleston's right across from that area, I'm opposed to this.
Thank you, Mr. Corbin.
Claire, do we have names? Olivio
Filippo Ravalico, good evening. I'm the program manager of the South Carolina Environmental Law Project. And on behalf of Save Our Sound, which is a community group of local residents, many of whom are in the room, and I'm glad to meet, we are opposing the project. We're opposing the application as proposed. You have submitted comment, public comments in a letter that we already submitted. I have a copy for you here, just for your reference. I'm not going to read it. It's all about, of course, the coastal zone management regulation. I probably want to just share a couple of very quick personal considerations. Of course, I'm not from around here. I do live in Charleston County, but I'm in Mount Pleasant, and I've been in the state just 3 years, so still at the beginning. I've picked up a couple of things in these 3 years, that is that the natural resources in this state are really world-class. The development pressure in this part of the state is really world-class. The coastal zone management regulatory system is all about striking a balance between the value of the resources and the competing and increasing demands of economic and demographic growth. I think any reasonable person, based on the existing rules we have on the books, would have a hard time to see as a project like this can be approved. And just because I heard about the irresistible economic growth point that was made by the company representative here, I hear you. Any company has definitely the desire and the right to keep growing. The question is whether this is the right place to do it. And I would even submit that someone, again, I understand it's been around for more than 100 years, so it's an institution, and I get it. Maybe 100 years ago was not the foresight that there was not the best place to fit industrial site like that. And so the fact that it's been there doesn't mean that it has to keep being there or keep growing there. That's all I have to say. Thank you.
Deborah Grant.
Good evening, I'm from Guatemala Island. I'm trying to make it real brief because I'm pretty much in agreement with some of what I've already heard. Got to keep one thing in mind is this. I'm quite sure you put a lot of planning into this. I'm quite sure you're looking forward to getting this done. But when it goes all wrong, then we have to deal with it, but you move on. That's something that we would like for you to take into consideration. Number two is that I'm very concerned about this growing extremely big. Once it becomes huge, large, etc., then here comes a highway through Wetmore, and that creates a big problem. Because right now, it's nice, it's quiet, it's sound, it's dead end, you can't go anywhere else. I love it just the way it is. So please take that into consideration, and please reconsider what you're doing.
Thank you.
That's everyone who signed up to speak. And as a result of this public hearing, the record will be kept open until November 3rd, 2017. Again, please make any additional comments that you'd like the agency to consider and forward them to us in writing. Thank you all for coming and have a good day.